very well. Excel is opening now. So basically, what are the applications of Excel and ఏం చెప్పాలంటే, so where you exactly use the Excel, so where in which forms you are using, you can use in the business side, you can use in the education based side, using the for analysis purpose. And you can be able to use them in healthcare. See here, this is the Excel file. In this Excel file, I am trying to save this file. How can you save? Either you have to go to the menu, file, save, or control S. So ఇప్పుడు సేవ్ అని కొట్టంగానే నాకు ఏమొస్తుందండి ఒక బాక్స్ వస్తుంది సో దిస్ బాక్స్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ ద డైలాగ్ బాక్స్ సో ఇదిలో ఏం చేస్తాము డైలాగ్ బాక్స్ మనం ఏదో ఒకటి ఇస్తాం ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు గివ్ సంథింగ్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ డెమో సో మీన్స్ ఏ యూజర్ కెన్ ఇంటరాక్ట్ విత్ ద ఎక్సెల్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ If you want to interact with the Excel, if a user want to interact with the Excel software, he need a communication a channel that we can call it as a dialog box. So dialog box are the boxes that are using to communicate a user with the MS Excel software. Example: if you want to save a file, if you want to open a file. Or if you want to search for specific content in Excel, see for example, I have targeted for A, here B, here C. So for example, Control F. This is also called a dialog box. This is also called a dialog box. Here, for example, if I ask for B, it will show the place where the B is existed. So this is the dialog box. These are called the dialog boxes. What are the ribbon tab and what are the types of the command in the tabs? So this is called the ribbon tab. This is called the ribbon tab. So in the ribbon tab, we have various commands. See an example. What are these commands? Example: cut, copy, paste, format painter, font style, font color, font size. Sorry. Alignments, number format, merge cells, conditional format, auto sum, auto filter, sort, everything. So we can simply what we can say is a ribbon tab contains commands that are available in all the menus. See, for example, home tab, we have some menus, insert, we have some menus, page layout, we have some menus. So means the ribbon tab will display the commands that are available in the menu. So if you select the home menu, it will display the home related. If you select the insert, will get the insert related. If you select the data, it will display the data related. So means the ribbon tab contains different commands of different menus. Example: home tab, what it contains. Insert tab, see here in home tab we can contains formatting text tools and alignment tools and formatting tools and auto sum and auto filter and everything. Whereas in case of insert tab, we can have a pivot table, shapes, pictures, charts. You can write anything if you want. So means what you have to define is here ribbon tab contains the commands that are available on each menu. So after describing example, when you take the home menu, this will contain this commands. Insert contain this commands. Page layout contain this commands. You have to explain. So it is not required to explain all the one. Whatever you want to remember, you can able to explain. For example, when you go to the insert home, you can able to explain the cut, copy, paste, and the alignments, left alignment, right alignment, justification, central alignment, and merge cells, wrap text, and the next one is the date, means the number formats, decimal places, how many decimal places you want, and how to sum, means how do you able to calculate the auto sum. So auto sum means, what if example, if I have given 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, if you want to add all this data, what you have to do means just to go here and click on the auto sum. Automatically the total sum will come here. So auto sum is a feature in Excel that is used to add values in a column at a time. The same way you can able to add values in a row at a time. So we are not using, we auto, the means the automatically the formula is appearing here. The sum function, automatically the function will call. So because by using the auto sum option in MS Excel, we can able to add elements either the row wise or column wise. So you can explain few buttons here, and also in the second, go to the few menus, mainly try to explain home, insert, and data. These three are better. Take one menu, three menus. From every menu, take 2 to 3 commands. That is enough. Next one, explain the functionalities of using cell, process, add, modify, move, copy, delete. So means, for example, if I have this cell, how do you move this cell content? How to add a new cell? How to delete a new cell? How to, add, modify, move, copy. See an example. Add means, for example, I have these two cells. If I want to add one more cell here, what I have to do? There are two methods. We have to right click on it and insert, and cells right or cells down. Cells right, and what will happen? Whatever the content here, that will move to the right side, and new empty cell will display. See example. So I click downward. That's why the 3 is come to the down next line, and one empty row will be here. See here, right click, insert, cells right. See here, right, it's moved to right side. If you specify that cells down, then it will come to down. So you can move the cell from right side or the downwards. The same way you can able to delete a cell from the upwards at the left side. So inserting means right and down, deleting means up and left. You have to remember clearly. Okay, how do you add the delete? How to add, how to insert? So I have inserted one cell. If I want to modify, how to modify the cell? Go to the specific cell and change the value. Simple. How to modify the content. And how to move? Control X. Go here, Control V. Otherwise, go to the specific cell and go to the home menu, click on the cut, and go to the place where you want to go placed, and go here and paste. This is another method. You can explain whatever you want to method. So if they ask the exam point of view, what you have to explain, either you can go through the shortcuts, it is good, better. Other, if you don't have this, if you don't have an idea about the shortcuts, go to the main menu itself. That is also a better one. So how do you do one? First, go to the specific cell which you want to move, and go to the home menu and click on the cut, and then go to the specific place where you want to move that one, and then again go to the home tab and press on the paste. Simple. This is move. If you want to copy, how do you copy? First, you have to go to the cell, which cell you want to copy. Then click on the home tab and go to the copy, and go to the specific place where you want to paste, and go and paste here. So this is how to paste. So it means how to insert, how to deceive. For example, I want to delete this cell 4. What happened when I delete this cell? Otherwise, the cell, we can go to left side or this side. For example, I have some value here. See an example. Right click, delete. Now it is asking, shift cells left. are shift cells up. When inserting, shift cells right and shift cells down. When deleting, shift cells left or shift cells up. So here, if I ask shift cells left, what will happen? The 4 will be deleted and 5 will be occupied the fourth place. See here. Otherwise, go to the second method, that is delete up. So what will happen? For example, I will change this as a 7. Okay. Now try delete cells up. See, fourth place is occupied by 7 and 7 place is occupied by 17. So this is about the operation we can able to perform on the cells. If you want to copy the group of cells at a time, you can copy. If you want to move group of cells, you can move. If you want to insert group of cells, you can insert. If you want to group of cells, delete, you can delete. For example, if you want to insert 3 rows at a time, you know how to go there. For example, 1, 2, 3. Select these things, click on the right and insert the left right down. See, for example, 3 lines are automatically, 3 cells are inserted. So if you want to insert number of cells, you can insert. If you want to only single cell, you can insert. If you want to delete number of cells, you can able to delete. Anything you can do. Okay, this is about the concept of functionalities using cell. What are the different data types in Excel? We already discussed in the earlier section also. We have to go to the for data or we go home. The home tab we have here. See. Okay. See here, when you go to the main tab, we have here the side. See, here we have, these are the different data types that we have. Explain those data types. General data type. It will accept characters, numbers, whatever you want to give. Number, it will accept only numbers. If you want to specify the new decimal places, you can able to specify. Currency, it will accept either rupees or dollars, what you want to specify, you can specify. Accounting, short date, long date. Short date means DD, MM, YY. Long date means 66th, for example, 10th July 2021. That is a long date format. And time, so you can able to display the percentage, fractions, etc. So when you go for the data test specifically, you can explain these things: general, number, currency, accounting, short date, long date, time. These are enough. If you explain those things, that is enough. Okay. Generally, you can able to insert. General means text, a number, or anything, special characters. If you specifically specify the text, you have to only enter the characters. Okay, see here, this is the text. So explain this one, this one, this one, this one first. If you have remember, go to these things. You can able to understand what is the short date and what is the long date. See an example, 11, 10, 21. This is a short date. If you select same thing and go here and select as a long date, then it will display 11th October 2021. So this is how to explain. That is enough. Different types of data types in Excel. General, number, currency, accounting, text. You know, just remember what you just explain them. See the functionality of sheets. So what are the functionality of sheets? We can able to insert a new sheet by clicking the plus symbol here. Otherwise, go to the select one sheet and click on the right click and insert a sheet. You can able to insert a new sheet. So you can use two ways. One, by clicking directly mouse to the plus point on the sheet tab. Otherwise, you can click on any sheet tab and right-click on it and select the shortcut option, Insert Sheet. There are two mechanisms you can do anything. The same way, if you want to delete, select the Sheet tab which you want to delete and right-click on it and select the Delete Sheet option. Clear. Move, how can you move? So if you, for example, if you want to sheet move from here to the next position, click on Move or Copy, go to the space where you want to move the sheet. See here, before sheet, sheet three. Means, example, we have sheet one, sheet two, sheet three in order. What I'm trying to do is, I want to move the sheet one before to the sheet three. Now, what will be the order here? Sheet two will be first come first, and sheet one, and next sheet three. Sheet two, see here, first sheet two, sheet one, sheet three. This is how we can be able to move. If you want to copy, means right click, same, select the move or copy sheet, select the place where you want to make it, for example, move to the end, means I want to move at the end. So here, click on create. So what happened here? The sheet one, which I am selecting, that will take a copy, and the copy of the sheet will be added to the end. See here. So this is how you can able to insert a sheet, how you can able to move a sheet, how you can able to copy a sheet, and how you can able to modify the sheet. The question that is modified nothing but changing the sheet names or changing the sheet tab colors. For example, right click on it, tab, go to the tab color, change the tab color, whatever you want, the tab color is changed. In the same way, you can, if you want to change the color, also, for example, you can, if you want to say the font size increases, you can increase the font size, say increase it. And if you want to change something different to it, you can do anything. You want to change the name, you can able to change the name, that is the rename. Go to, for example, work, book or work notes, something, whatever, maybe you can change the name, you can change the font also, font, font size, tab colors. So you can able to change the font also. It's not optional, it's staying here. Yes, okay. Now see, the color is clear, blue color. So if you want to change this color to another color, tab color, you can change it to some, for example, red. You can change it to red. So what is modify means? We can able to change the name of the tabs, and we can able to change the color of the tabs. That you have to remember. That is for the modification. So how to insert a sheet? How to insert a, how to delete a sheet, and how to modify a sheet, and how to copy the sheet. Next one, process of contiguous and non-contiguous selections process. We already discussed in the class earlier also. How do you select the continuous cells and non-continuous cells? So how do you select the continuous cells? Click on to the first cell where you want to start, and click on the mouse. Hold the mouse and drag to up to the location where you want to. This is one method. Next method, go to the first cell, hold down the shift key, and go to the cells from right side area, and also go to the cells to the downside. So this is another method. This is through keyboard, that is through mouse. This is the continuous cells. And how can you do the non-continuous cells? Means you have to hold this shift F7. I already explained the concept. I will explain. You have to hold it F8. Go here and press F8. Something wrong here. Mm-hmm. Okay, I will explain you. I will send the notes to you about the how to select the non-contiguous that you can write, no problem. Okay. So I think you have an idea about the continuous cell first of all. So first one way is you go to the first cell and click on the EVO shift key and go to the right side or go to the down side. You can able to select the multiple cells at a time. Otherwise, click on the mouse, the first cell, hold on the mouse and drag it to the place where you want to select. These are two types. Next, define the range, explain the process of working with range. What is the range? Ranging nothing but the group of cells. Ranging is nothing but the group of cells. For example, A1 to D10. A1 colon D10. This is called the range. So means the cell A1 to cell D10. How many cells will be there? There are A, B, C, D, 4 columns and 1 to 10 rows. So 4 into 10, 40 cells. Total number is here 40 cells. And for example, B5 to F5. So how many cells will be here? B5 to F5. So row number is same. Row number not changing anywhere. B5 to F5. B5, C5, D5, E5, F5. Total number of cells is 5. This is the range. This is the range. Where you use the range? If you want to do add multiple cells, or if you want to do multiple formulas with that multiple operations, for example, here see, sum of I4 colon I12. So here colon represents the range. Colon represents the range from where I4 to I12. How do you get the range? By selecting the rows or columns, you can able to get the range. When you use the range, when you want to do some average or sum or maximum or minimum, in those cases, we can able to use the range. So range is nothing but a group of cells from starting position to the ending position. Example, A1 colon to A10, A1 colon to A10 or A1 colon to D10. So what exactly it will tell is the first cell start from A1 and last cell end with A10. First cell start with A1 and the last cell end with a D10. So you can also write an example that by the example itself. For example, it'd be like this. 1, 2, 3. You can draw like this. 4, 5, 6. Then you can specify that this is B2 colon D3. So how do you mean first cell is B2? See here, we are able to see here the cell reference B2. Last cell is D3. So B2 colon D3. So this is called the range. Range is nothing but the group of cells. The range contains the starting and ending number. So starting, we will have to specify the cell reference colon followed by the end cell reference. Example B2 colon D3. You can write simple table like this and specify the space. But you have to specify the column numbers also here, of course. You have to write like this. B, C, D, here 1, 2. Now, this is clear. B1, B2, D2. Simple. If you write, this is enough. That is about the range. Where we work with the range, we use range in finding averages, sum, maximum, minimum. It means that the statistical functions. As the statistical functions, we can able to use this one. See here, we can able to use this one either in the financial functions, are in the statistical functions. Statistical means mean, mode, median. If you want to count, take them also, you can do. example, if you want to explain the example, count, max, min, average, sum, mean, mode, median, etc. You can write. Next one, explain the various functionalities of the table. What is the table? Table is the collection of rows and columns. What is the advantage or basic advantage of the table? To represent the data in a tabular form. So what is the functionality of the table? You can create your own format for the tables. One advantage. You can able to create your own table format. You can able to sort the data in a specific order also. You can able to take the conditional formatting for the tables. You can able to put the conditional format for the tables. The main basic idea behind creating the tables is to represent the data in a tabular form for better understanding. So by point of the functionalities, the main purpose is to represent the data in a tabular form. Next one, to apply the auto formats, to apply the conditional formats, etc. Next one, what is the sorting and its type? Sorting means arranging the data, given data in a particular order. It is nothing but a sorting. Sorting is a process of arranging the data on a specific column, So what is the advantage of sorting? Because of sorting, we can able to get the data clear. If you want to explain, you can explain. How do you explain? See an example. Take an example like this. Serial number, marks. 1, 5, 3, like this. 45, for example, like this. When you see this one, someone please unmute the voice. When you take this table, what we can understand here is that the data is neither sort on the serial number not sort on the marks. If you want to sort, what I have to sort is first I have to select the entire range. After selecting, next I have to go to the data tab and select the sort. It will ask on what column you want to sort. Now select the serial number column and click on OK. Now the data is sorted on the serial number column. This you have to write. First, before sorting, how the data look like. After sorting, how the data look like. Sorting is there of two types, ascending order and descending order. Take an example, first do it on the ascending order, then redo it on the descending order. Simple. This is the sorting. We can have options in sorting that sort by and then by. Sort by means on first level, on which column you want to sort, at the second level, which column you want to sort. Example, I have huge amount of data. First, I want to sort on the city based. So sort by city. Then again, I want to sort the data based on the area. For example, Lakade, Kapol, Pukadapalli, like this. Then I have to take sort by city, then by Pukadapalli. Otherwise, state, under the state, district under mandal, like. So if you want to explain, you can able to explain the data also. How do you explain, sir? See, add some more thing, for example, city and place. I'm just taking example. Don't take this example. You can do better one. Okay. Or otherwise, production. Okay. Take this example. For example, 340, 540, some 300, like this. city, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Hyderabad. See, for example, Kukatpally. For example, Majestic. Bachpally. So this is my data. First, I have to select this data, then sort. Then it will ask that on what base. First, I have to take the select the city. Then click on the add level and select the next by place. See, this is the data before. This is the data before. Now the data first, it will take the city. So both Hyderabad will come onto the first place. From that, Bachpally will come to the first place and Kukatpally come to the next place. So this is called sort by and then by. This you have to explain clearly. Anything, first take the example and then show the result. Next one, filters. What is the use of filters? If you have huge amount of data, filters are used to get the information from an existing data, required information from the existing data. If I have large amount of data or huge amount of data, and if I want to look for the specific person, a specific information is too difficult to search. That's why we can use the filters. How do you use the filters? Filters, when you click on the, go to the data tab and click on the filter, then your filters will be applied. We, using the filter, you can able to select, see the individual record, or if you select the group of records, or if you can able to select the records based on the specific condition. So you can able to select the individual record, you can able to select the group of records, you can able to select the records based on the criteria. It is with the condition. See an example here, filter. The filters are being added here. Now see here, if I want to see only the Majestic or the Bachpally, I will remove all the things here, click on unchecked and select only Bachpally. Then I will be able to get the information about only the Bachpally itself. This is one advantage. Next one, otherwise if you want to select the group, see here, remove this one and take cancel here, click on here, city. So here we have Hyderabad only, select all Hyderabad and Bangalore. Sorry, first I have to select all. So every record will come again. Now click on this one and select only the Bangalore. Now you are able to, otherwise select only the Hyderabad. Now we get only the records, that is Hyderabad and all the records for places. This is the nothing but a filter. This is the group of records. Now you are getting the group of records. Earlier you have get the individual record. And if you want to specify the condition, also you can specify the record. How, if you want to know, see an example. Greater than 300. It means that the production is no problem. The net is offing and Zoom timing is offing. Now I will reconnect again, open up. Once it disconnected, you reconnect it, no problem. So this is greater than 300. So when you go to the art of advanced filter, you can able to specify the condition here. See here, it is selecting the range. First you go here and select the range like this. Now it's asking about the criteria range. Remove this one. What we want, production. So in the production, greater than 300. This is my criteria. Okay. Now go to the advanced filter. Select the range here first. This is my range of data. From this range of data, I am giving the condition that the condition is here, this one. Select these two cells first. Enclose and okay. Now see, what do you get the information? Is the information changed or not? See. Now you are getting the records whose production is more than 300. This is the advantage of using the auto filters, advanced filter. So filter, we can able to get the specific record or group of records. With the help of the advanced filter, you can able to records under specific condition. See here example, I will explain once again. See here, you can able to see all the records now. Okay, we have 300, 540 and 350. If I specify the condition that more than 400, then what will happen? These three records will not displayed, only this record will be displayed. See, go to the advanced filter and select the range. The range is already selected, very good. Now go to the criteria range, click on it and select these two cells. So then go to here and okay. See, only you have got 540. So this is the advanced filter. So means that you can get the information from the table or the data by specifying the specific condition or for the individual record or group of records with the help of